Mr. Giz, yesterday afternoon, I visited the Hemlock Grove in Bonshaw and witnessed the slashing and destruction of the trees, the tread marks of heavy machinery going into the stream, the oil slicks on the once pristine water, and the pathetic little layer of hay and brush, which is supposed to be erosion control, and the silt clinging to everything. There is so much amiss with the whole concept and execution of the Plan B road that it cannot be documented in one short letter. However, I will note that as an Islander by choice, some of my primary reasons for coming to PEI were the feeling of safety, the beautiful rolling hills and valleys, and the winding roads. Now the feeling of safety has vanished. Some of the most beautiful hills are to be raised, the valleys are to be filled, and a winding road through the soul of PEI is to become Giz's highway of shame. This hemlock seedling is just one of many that will stand as monuments to the trees and habitats that have been and will continue to be destroyed during the systematic rape of one of PEI's most beautiful and ecologically significant areas. It will also stand as a guardian against further betrayals of trust and decency. And I call upon you to pledge responsibility for its safety as it grows. Perhaps in 200 years, when this tree is mature and you and I are dust, our descendants, our great-grandchildren's great-grandchildren, will demonstrate the true meaning of progress by not cutting it down. In your name, I will plant this tree at Churchill in what I hope will be a safe place overlooking the site of the Plan B debacle. Will you take responsibility for this tree?
Very good, thank you, Judith. And next we have Quinn Skerr, who's, well, he can explain who he's presenting his to. So if you want to come up, Quinn.
Okay.